What college?
King's.
King's. What's the most memorable thing about Cambridge that you, from your time there?
Leaving.
The varsity match between Oxford and Cambridge is the physical representation of the intellectual battle that these two universities constantly fight. Now that I've used up all the big words I know, I'm going to go chat to their students. I'm Max Bosch, and welcome to StreetSmart. What does the varsity match represent? Why do we have the varsity match? What does it mean? Why do we do it? Why are we here? What is God?
I won't answer the last question.
Good, yeah, stay away from that old kettle of fish.
I think in some ways it represents a rivalry, and in other ways it represents unity.
Good.
That was good, wasn't it?
The female one represents female empowerment, I think.
Good spectacle, good chance to get everyone back together.
Is that what this is today, an opportunity to get everyone back together, in which two of you have turned up? What's the most common response that you get from people when you tell them that you go to Oxford?
Ooh.
How on earth are you there? Was mine.
Was yours?
Yeah.
And you're like, Mum, please, I got in on merit.
I do PPE, so it tends to be a response of, oh, you're going to be the next Prime Minister then.
And are you?
Yeah, of course, yeah. Every PPEist actually becomes the next Prime Minister.
I did hear that.
Yeah. To be fair, most of my friends are from Oxford, so,
yeah, so. You
know, like, it's hardly a surprise.
Yeah, hardly a surprise.
All right, mate, I knew you went to Oxford. You don't need to tell me every time we meet.
It's normally, like, silence.
Right.
Yeah, it kind of ends the conversation.
What is the first rule of rugby?
Don't pass it forwards.
Yeah. What if... Will, what's the first rule of rugby?
Put your head up the guy in front's arse.
That must be a Cambridge thing.
Shoe the tabs.
Okay.
That you can hold the ball, I guess, as opposed to...
It's kicking it.
As opposed to association football.
That you can. Also known as football.
Don't tackle above the waist.
Don't tackle above the head, because then you'll miss them. What do you wish the media would portray about Oxbridge?
These are really insightful questions.
I Thanks. Asking,
like, the capital of Uzbekistan or something like this. But
do you know it?
No, obviously not. Do you?
No.
I think the stereotype is that everybody's posh, but I'm not sure if that's the case.
What's an inside joke that I wouldn't understand?
GDBO is like the Cambridge like hashtag for sport when they're playing.
What does it mean? Giant... I'm not quick enough to think of a D, B or O.
Oh, I thought you were quite quick like this.
No, it's editing. It's all editing. I've realised that there's a lot of tweed and a lot of beige going on. So, new segment, tweed and beige watch. What Baywatch was called before Hasselhoff got involved.
Okay.
GDBO.
Got that bloody Oxford.
Oh, hat tweed. Nice. Who's the most famous member of either Oxford or Cambridge?
After this interview, after being publicised across StreetSmart.
StreetSmart.
Yeah, I think I will be the most famous.
You, Ed.
University.
Generally, probably Isaac Newton.
Yeah.
Newton.
Then you've got people like Hugh Laurie and...
Osler.
Benedict Cumberbatch.
Cumbo.
John Cleese went to our college. He's quite a funny bloke, you know?
Yeah, he is a friend.
I had his room in first year.
Is he in there?
No.
David Attenborough.
Dave Attenborough? We've got some cracking tweets in 3, 2, 1. I don't go to Oxford or Cambridge. Oh. I was at Newcastle.
Okay.
Well done.
Okay. What do you study? Are you on the same MBA? I don't know what that means.
Master of Business Administration.
I now know what that means.
It's a nice little reunion.
Nice little reunion. Is this all the friends you guys made at university?
Yeah. Did well.
This is it.
You surprised me. Well, enjoy your newfound fame, Ed.
Thank
you
very much.
Lovely to meet you and have a good day.